What's good, YouTube? It's your girl, She Carry, and today I'm going to teach you guys how to play claw. We're going to get into the types of claw, types of grips, best control, the right way to hold it, the way you want to hold it, stuff like that. Before the video starts, make sure you subscribe to me, turn on post notifications, and make sure you like the video. It's such a banger. Let's get into it. Okay, one of the big reasons to play claw is because it makes you play way better. Instead of taking your finger off the thumbstick and pressing the faceplate, you have your finger on the thumbstick continuously while pressing the faceplate, which means your movement is smoother, your gameplay is smoother, and very more efficient. You see what I'm saying? Your reaction time is on deck. As you see your favorite pros, your favorite Reaper players, your favorite Warzone players, not even just Warzone, any other FPS game or shooting game or anything like that, they play claw. Another big reason to play claw, and I feel like this is the number one reason, is because it's the cheapest option. As you see, some pros use SCUF controllers, which can range up from $170 to $300. Battle Beavis, which takes 4 months to get to you, or anything like paddles that cost $40 extra. That is too much money. You can use a regular PS4 controller, PS5, or Xbox controller that you can get from $60 to $80 at your local gaming store or Amazon or whatever, and just play claw on it. Unlike spending $300 on a SCUF controller and then later getting that stick drift 3 months later or breaking, now you have to take another $300 out your pocket to get the exact same controller that you learned your playstyle on. Switching to claw will result in better gameplay for your content if you play content, or just better gameplay in general. You do not want to be left behind. As you see, everyone who plays claw in a game significantly abuses that power. I'm now going to put on the screen of a bunch of Rebirth players and pro players or whatever, how they play claw. As you can see, very versatile, different controllers. Just look at their gameplay. And I recommend going to YouTube, searching up claw players, just any game, especially the game that you play, and see how they play. You might want to replicate it or use it or whatever. But as you could tell, all of them are smooth. They're not doing too much. See, when you play like regular grip, you have to go back and forth and it's kind of chaotic, but it's smooth. The reaction time are amazing, bro. Their reaction time is crazy, bro. You can be like that if you play claw. And if you remember to play claw, you're a freaking go. I don't even know why you're watching this video, but it's probably to support me, so mwah. I ain't gonna lie, I sound too proper in this audio. Okay, my bad. Okay, different types of claw. Regular claw, basically right-handed claw. As you see right here in this picture, this is right-hand claw, which is regular claw. Next picture is double claw. Basically, you play claw but on both hands, and then hybrid claw, which I say is people switching off a hand, and I feel like that goes into like octopus grip, squid grip, dragon claw, and all that weird stuff. But on the other hand, I recommend just regular claw or double claw, which is the easiest to learn. I feel like it's very, you know, beginner friendly. So yeah. Okay, this is how I play claw. As you can see, instead of having one finger on the back like everyone else, since my hands, since my hands are small, I have to put two back there. You see, like that? So basically, I only really have my pinky finger holding my controller. So that's why I have to kind of play in my lap, or it does hurt like at first, but now it doesn't. But that's just how I started, and it really did strain my pinky finger when I started playing, and the third day was so bad. But this is how I play. Now, some people have trouble reaching the stuff, especially if you have smaller hands, but if you tilt and rotate your wrist, it's better to hold and you grip it on the back better. It's just more comfortable. So you do whatever you think is more comfortable. And if you have bigger hands, you might have to use like the one, or like tilt your hand the other way, whatever works for you. Or you might have to get a control freak. The next grip is double claw. So basically you do what on the right side you do on the left side, double claw. The only tip I have a double claw really is just to make sure you're very comfortable. Just like basically copy and paste what I said first, but whichever is more comfortable. If you want to put the back finger up on the back, whatever side, a little bit more, and tilt your hand, or play in your lap, which is ever more comfortable, I wouldn't recommend playing double claw, because I feel like it's the only need, because you don't really have binds on the left side of your controller unless you just have unique binds. I feel like it looks really good for content. So if you want to switch the claw and you want views, I would say switch to double claw, because it does look kind of cool. Like I said, I suggest playing with control fingers if you have bigger hands because you can reach it and stuff like that. But if you have shorter fingers like mine, I would say go the way that I'm going at first, especially for you ladies or men with smaller hands. Play claw how I play it. Just try it for a day and stuff like that. Now we get into hybrid claw. Basically, it's like regular claw, right? Just say you're in a game and you get into a fight. And you had to do something with your left hand. Just switch real quick. And then after you get on the fight, you just go back to like a regular grip on your left hand. That's kind of like a hybrid, you know, type way. In my definition. Now, some people change the name throughout the years. But yeah, that's kind of like hybrid. So I used to do hybrid while playing Fortnite. I used to edit my touchpad if y'all do play Fortnite. So I used to play kind of like hybrid claw. Double claw slash hybrid claw. That's like in the same area. Now that we get to Octopus Claw and Dragon Claw, I'm gonna put like videos on the screen or pictures, whatever. I'm not really looking. And that's what it is. I recommend not going for that because I feel like that looks painful or like really annoying to learn. But I feel like it's very good for content. But then again, if you try those and those are very comfortable, whatever works for you. Those kids are just demons. I'm not gonna lie. Also, I meant to mention, I'm not going to say it depends on what controller you play on. Some people like playing claw on the PS4 better because it's smaller. And when they switch to the PS5, they don't like it because it's a little bit more bulkier. And another reason, some people think they play claw better on PS4, PS5 controllers better than Xbox. But then some people like Xbox. So I will say pick your main controller and stick to that because it's just better and more comfortable. But if you want to switch to an Xbox, like you see, I have multiple controllers. And so I tested them all and I feel like PS5 just fits my fingers really good, even though I have small fingers. So yeah, now we're gonna get into the tips and tricks of claw. So it takes about a week to get used to claw. I say 7 days a week if you play the game at least for 4 hours a day. Now if you don't play the game a lot, then it's gonna take longer. I recommend grinding the game for 7 days. I promise you, you'll get it in a week. Do practice modes. Make sure if you have Modern Warfare, go into the private matches and, you know, shoot the bots. I wouldn't recommend going into games because it's very annoying and you will get destroyed. I'm not gonna lie, and it's gonna be demotivating. You dying and you're gonna switch back. I recommend it going to bots. I recommend 1v1 to friends. Don't 1v1 your friend with the ego. 1v1 your trash IRL so he won't, you know, whatever. They don't care, they just want to play the game. That's what I do, because that's what I did. Because when I was first learning claw, I was on Fortnite. I did not go into matches or nothing like that. I was just in creative, just building or playing against IRLs because I knew they were ass. And then as I gradually got better, I went into matches and I started 1v1 with my friends. It's just like I was saying, it's basically repetition. That's what I meant, bro. I'm such a bad voiceover. Okay, yeah, repetition. And then after that, it takes a week to learn claw and gisu, but it takes like a month. Like in a month, you just be like, I know this. Like this is, I feel like I've been playing claw for years, you know. Just repetition, bro. But that's really all I can tell you guys. If you have any questions or concerns, please put them in the comments down below. If you guys enjoyed this video, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. And yeah, thank you for tuning in. And you guys better switch the claw. If you really want to, just do it, bro. Just for a week. Just switch, bro. It's not that hard. I promise you. At first it is. You think that, bro, that second, third day is horrible. But after that, it's just a breeze. I see you guys in the next video. Bye.